So we're here really in Spain. Messages from back home from some of our partners and potential investors talking about vlogs and vlog series and discussing really how we should be doing that for Manchester Central and how it can attract a bit of a user base. So maybe giving it a go, trying to get people into the spirit just before we get into pre-season and the competitive fixtures. So so we'll see if we can gloss over some of the things of the the conception of the club and what's going on, and see if we can reflect on things while we're away from England. So yeah, here in Moraira, thinking about vlog series and how you do that really in a football sense. A lot of entrepreneurs do that, a lot of businesses do that, new businesses, certainly in the tech industry. But with the advice we've been given and the way to go forward to promote kind of a user base and people logging in and looking at what's going on, and I think it is probably a good time to reflect and see what's going on and build up really to pre-season, which starts on Saturday. You can't be in better surroundings than kind of here in Moraira, which is a beautiful setting, place we would like to just speaking to people here now in a few bars and restaurants and stuff, and trying to sort out maybe a group of players coming over here next summer. Couple of villas, shares, couple of apartments, all the bars here and the restaurants, more than accommodating to what you want to do in terms of group numbers. So just something we're looking to do really with Manchester Central, make the club big, make the club, grow and be something that players really enjoy being part of. So yeah, while being away as the manager and the chairman as well as the club, a lot of maybe weight on my shoulders to maybe make this club kick on. So yeah, interesting. So we'll see what we can come up with really, I suppose. It probably goes without saying this, advice to do a vlog. Keep it going throughout pre-season, throughout the season, and basically try and, video document everything we do really. Tell the story, let it work for us, let it grow and work 24/7 while we're not really doing anything. Let people around the world see it. Not just local, we want people to take an interest in this from anywhere around the world. If you're a guy that's moved away from, like I said, Manchester, Greater Manchester, and want to keep an interest in football and local football, then, a vlog series, certainly of a club like Manchester Central, would probably be quite appealing, really. So the idea is to document everything we do, not just me, obviously, hopefully not just me, or that'll get a bit boring, the other staff members, the players, match footage, even little snippets of training, little snippets of behind the scenes, the highs and the lows, the arguments, the rows, the celebrations. If we can document a lot of that stuff, then I think that sets us apart really, because I don't see many other clubs doing that. I don't know why. Maybe they don't want to, maybe they don't think it's in their circle of competence, I really don't know. But all I know is that if you've got a good story and you're doing things right, let people see it, let it grow, let people watch it, let people make their own opinions really, and if that makes you go from strength to strength, then fantastic, that's the plan. If people don't like it, don't want to watch it, then fine, no one has to. But if anything, it's something for our children to watch in a few years' time when they think, look what these were doing. So, myself, Jonathan Davis, Rob Green, Chris Haynes, James Wallace, Chris Hurst, Lance Jones, everyone that works for us within our academy and within Manchester Central Football Club, let's document things, let's vlog it and let's get it out there and let people make up their own opinions. Won't be great, be a bit rough and ready like my one is now, but in the end, I think, with the help of some of our partners, we've got a fantastic opportunity really with where we are at the regional arena, because next door to us we've got a major football university next door, 400 to 800 students all needing to do the kind of work experience, get the foot on the ladder in all different spheres, finance, marketing, promotions, coaching, playing, everything. So we're going to try to tap into that kind of thing, and help them meet their needs whilst helping us grow and develop. So that's the plan. So there'll be little snippets of all that stuff going on. Like I say, hopefully it won't just always be me. It'll probably be me more often than not. But got to get everyone doing it, and we've got to get everyone thinking, you know, that this is the way forward. Let's let everyone see what we're doing and see if it works. Well, it was a great first season. You know, we had an under-18 team in the Lancashire Flood Lit League. We also had an under-21 team in the Chester under-21 League. Both finished really, really high position. I think both finished third in the league. You know, you'll be able to see that at our website, which if you probably look at the link below, it'll guide you to our website. And, you know, the two brand new teams did fantastic. Probably better than I thought, actually. Certainly under-21s, you know, playing against some good teams in that league. Thought we might take a few good hide-ins, maybe finish towards the bottom of the league, but we finished third, just behind Earlham and Southport. So you can't really do much better than that in your first season. So obviously we took massive strides forward in setting up a senior team, a first team, in effect, that will play in the Manchester League next season, starting early August. Got a fantastic ground to play at, which is the Manchester Regional Arena down at Sport City there, next door to the Etihad. So, you know, you can't have a better ground. You know, that was the big problem, really. We tried to play at Bellevue, went round the houses with that loads and loads of times on the pitch dimensions, tried to play there. It's where Manchester Central as a football club played back in 1928 when it was first founded. And, you know, we tried to play at our previous home, but unfortunately we couldn't. You know, maybe we will. The 21s will still play there. Under-19s and under-18s will still play there. But the first team, what with the ground grading criteria, needed a better ground, a bigger ground, if you like, really. And no greater place than the Manchester Regional Arena. You know, so far, fantastic support down there from the staff there that work there. Great people, yeah, really helpful. And I think, really, that's probably the best place in Manchester we could play. You know, 6,500 all-seater. Running track, you know, changing rooms, scope for development. You know, fantastic base to play our football from. So, you know, we've got the training ground and the training ground down at Bellevue Sports Village. They will train there on Thursday nights. Fantastic facility, brand new. You know, indoor sports halls, gym, everything really. And the guys down there are fantastic as well with us, the facility guys. So we'll train at Bellevue on Thursday nights. We'll play our Saturday games at the Regional Arena. And, you know, the future's really, really, really bright. It's really exciting. So it is nice to come away, like I say, to a place such as this, really. You know, kind of gather your thoughts, think about kind of what's going on, and be ready for it, really. Be ready for it, that's all I can say. That's probably the beauty of Manchester Central, really, the mad things that happen in a short space of time. Just as I'm going between videos, just got a call from James Wallace there, a few WhatsApps talking about the free kit scheme from McDonald's. We're a charter standard club now, as many as might know. Again, that's on probably on our website. We probably need to make more of that. So as a charter standard club, we're entitled to claim a free kit from the McDonald's kit scheme. So I've just been through that with him, picking the colours, making sure it's the white and black vibe. You know, we debated over the red socks. Should we stick with the red socks? And I think we will certainly do a first season with white, black, red. You know, it's a good theme of colours, good way to do it. So yeah, thanks to Nike and the McDonald's kit scheme. So, you know, one of our teams will be playing in that kit next season. Who knows which one? Probably maybe under-18s, I think it'll be, one of the college sides. But I'm sure we'll get good use out of that. So well done to, maybe we'll put a link in here somewhere as well, McDonald's and Charter Standard Club and the free kit scheme. So well done. Sorted it. I'd take care of you anytime, everywhere. So I'll tell you what is absolutely brilliant. Just learned from a local guy here. He knows the local football club called Javi Amigos or something. Play in similar colours to us, red, black and white, or there or thereabouts. They've got an AstroTurf pitch just down in Javier in the old town. So he said pre-season friendlies around this time of the year. Spain, apparently their league start a little bit later than ours, so teams coming over or group of clubs coming over in kind of July, you know, this kind of time. He said they love to have friendlies. He said they have friendlies every 2 minutes. So he said they do beach football. Some of their clubs train on the beach down in Javier. Take a little snapshot of that later when I go down there. So they were talking about, you know, they do beach football, small-sided stuff. But yeah, they got a full-size 11-a-side 3G pitch with a little stand apparently. So and they kind of start back about this time, but their season starts later. So probably fits in pretty well with the back end of pre-season in England. And if we keep all the guys like him and maybe get some details off him and stuff before we go, there you go. That's another box ticked in terms of bringing your club and a squad of players over here to do pre-season training. So, you know, something I'd want to do, you know, in terms of camaraderie, team building, get a bit of sun on your back, you know, take the lads out, let them have a bit of fun. I think that's the way forward, personally. Yeah. Bring them players like this. Let them see. That's when these young lads see the barmaids won't ever kill them, will it? Okay, great stuff. Also, yeah, just a thought, it'd be good if people would let us know what they want to see on vlogs, whether it's from, you know, match action to training to behind the scenes interviews to player interviews, whatever really. If people could maybe send messages to the link below, let us know what you'd want to see from a club, from an up and coming kind of amateur / semi-pro club, and see if it's something that, you know, we can do for you, and if it's what entertains people and people want to see. And I suppose that's what we do. So yeah, let us know. Go to the links below. Let us know what you'd want to see. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah, we'll never be alone. Savannah. Well, yeah, it's probably quite important to have a think really about, you know, where we're trying to get to, because most people will probably say to you, you know, what's the point, what's behind all this? Well, in reality, you know, the academy that we set up, you know, grown kind of out of our hands really, in terms of the exit routes we needed to create for our players. Waste of time trying to get them to play for most local football clubs, even in and around Greater Manchester. You know, you could probably have Lionel Messi in your midst, but if you try to turn up to someone's club and hand them over, don't really want to know. I'll be really honest about that. So, you know, everyone else has their own way of doing things, and, you know, I've learned to embrace that now, to be honest. So doing it our own way, so we had to develop our own club, we had to have the exit route. You know, everyone wants to bang on about, you know, oh, X player into the first team, we've got this player into the reserves. Well, look, if we've got our own club, we'll get them through, loads of them, as many as we want, but obviously they've got to be quality, got to be able to do a job at senior level. So now, you know, any lad coming from our academy can basically play, you know, under 18s, under 19s, reserves and first team, and that if they're good in the Manchester League. And you know, our big plan is to get through the Manchester League as soon as we can, doing it the right way, and get ourselves into the North West Counties. That's the plan. Whether that takes 2 years or 5 years, who knows? You know, I hope it's two, but you know, it could be longer, but there's no major rush. So, you know, primary goal is get ourselves in the North West Counties, you know, become a club that can contract players, and we can, you know, get the FA Cup runs and do all the usual stuff really that all these clubs want to do. So, you know, Manchester Central has shown unbelievable growth in one season. In one season, we've got 50 players turning up to pre-season on Saturday. We've got five squads of teams. We've got backing from the Manchester County FA, backing from places like, you know, MMU and Manchester Regional Arena and Eastlands Trust. So far, we can't complain. You know, we don't want to put a foot wrong. We want to make all the stakeholders happy and pleased with what we're doing. And I think there's an extremely bright future. It's just a case now getting back, getting pre-season underway, trying to work out the players, who's good, who's indifferent, you know, who can compete and commit and turn up to training and turn up for games. You know, that's what's critical really, having, you know, a good solid group of players that are committed. We can make them better. You know, I'm an A-licensed coach, got lots of good coaches working with us. We can make players better, but if they're not going to turn up and not going to show commitment, we can't do anything for them. So, you know, let's see if that happens, and you know, the benefits are there for everybody. If, you know, the pre-season tour here, you know, next season playing in Javier, going to Alacante, visiting some teams in Benidorm, you know, that's what we want to do. So, you know, for people on a plane out here next year, then it's been an amazing season. So that's one of the plans really. yeah, probably just a bit of a view really on how we're starting and shaping up for pre-season, which is a bit probably shorter and more condensed than most clubs for us. Probably trying to ride off the back of people going to a lot of pre-seasons, trying to get in themselves at clubs, going training with everyone, and then really being a bit stuck really for where to go. So we you know, we plan to start up on Saturday, you know, the 16th, do some training, probably, like I say, up to maybe 50 lads expected to that, you know, across our various teams and certainly reserves and first team. And follow that on Tuesday by some track work down at our home ground at the regional arena. You know, not many grounds are going to have an athletics track, not many clubs, sorry, going to have an athletics track to do a lot of their work, which we are, so we time the lads, you know, not make it too crazy, but, you know, the mixture and the variety of the training in terms of, you know, full-size 3G, track, indoor track, you know, that's how we're going to, so we're going to condense pre-season into about 2.5 weeks, see quite a lot of footfall of players coming and going, you know, some stick, some leave, some you never see again. So, you know, really, for any players out there that ever want to come down, all they need to do is get hold of us, you know, maybe contact me on the link down here or one of the other coaches and just introduce yourself to us. Let us know where you've played, you know, who you've been, what teams you've been in and around, how old you are, what your position is, and we'll invite anybody down. No one's a time waster for us. You know, we'll get you down, we'll have a look at you, we'll try to treat you fairly, get you involved in training, get you involved in some matches, give you a fair crack of the whip really. And the top and bottom of it in football, as I see it, is if you can have an effect for us on a football pitch and then for the betterment of the team, you know, help us win points, help us win games, then you're in. Don't really care, you know, you're good, bad or ugly really, as long as you can contribute to the team and you're a decent lad. But, you know, come down, we've got one of the best training facilities around. Not many amateur or semi-pro clubs will train at the places we train or play at the places we play. So come down, contact us, like I said, introduce yourself, give us a little bit of background and get down to training or matches and we'll have a good look at you. You know, we've got a few good pre-season friendlies coming up, you know, some that might be a bit tough for us, some hopefully a little bit easier. And then the season will start, you know, the first Saturday in August and it'll be lively.